Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor for me to have the opportunity to participate in the Pan-African Movement for the Culture of Peace and Nonviolence at the invitation of UNESCO, the African Union, and the government of Angola. Our gathering on the occasion of the Luanda Biennale is momentous because it expresses our deeper conviction that peace should always prevail despite any challenges it may face. Today, African countries and peoples are struggling to address the onslaught of COVID-19 and the ways in which it has impacted issues like health, the economy, and social cohesion. We cannot ignore that in many places affected by fragility, the pandemic has both exacerbated existing tensions and created new ones. The virus reminds us that peace is never a given. Peace must be constantly nurtured through efforts by everyone. This is why we need to foster a culture of peace and nonviolence at all levels. A culture of prevention and reconciliation filled with a set of values, attitudes, and behaviors that will afford African citizens and leaders with the capacity to address conflicts in a spirit of solidarity. We cannot avoid the rise of conflicts, but we can control our work to prevent them from degenerating into violence. Governments and regional organizations have a stake in this effort. They have the power to silence weapons, as was called upon by the African Union, but they also have the power to strengthen the foundations of long-term peace, ensuring that the very fabric of African societies is imbued with a culture of peace. This is within our reach, as was recognized by the African leadership when they unanimously adopted the Sustainable Development Goals. Concerted efforts will lead to strengthening education systems that instill positive attitudes and values in the minds of children and youth. It will also lead to improved policies for eliminating social, racial, and gender-based discriminations in all areas of economic, social, and cultural life. In this regard, I fully subscribe to the focus of the Biennale on the arts, culture, and heritage, which are truly levers to build the Africa we want. As UNESCO's Special Envoy for Peace and Reconciliation, as an actor, a director, and a producer, I'm well aware that the arts, culture, and heritage are a unique vector which can be utilized to raise awareness about the importance of peace, as well as the role each of us can have in creating and maintaining it. This gathering will fulfill its purpose if we can contribute to the fostering of Pan-African Movement for Peace that builds on the energy of everyday people. The more individuals and communities we reach, the more tangible the culture of peace will be. This is something I witness every day through my peace-building work with young women and men from conflict and violence-affected areas in South Africa, South Sudan, and Uganda. Our work starts with training a handful of talented young women and men as peace-builders and entrepreneurs. Then we support them to take initiatives in their home communities. They go into their villages to mediate land conflicts, they create businesses, they provide services and jobs, they inform local populations about how to keep safe from health concerns, like preventing the spread of COVID-19. Day by day, the combined effort and effect of their actions gradually improves conditions for peaceful relations among individuals and entire communities. Their accomplishments hold a lesson for us today. A Pan-African culture of peace can be spread effectively, even in incredibly remote areas, if we empower African youth as agents of transformative change in their communities and beyond. Thank you for your attention.